Hi, my name is Bintu and today I am going to teach you how to write a C program for matrix multiplication. Matrix multiplication is very important in two-dimensional arrays in C. I dedicate this lecture to my computer science school teachers, Sir R.P. Sharma and Geeta Nayyar ma'am. I don't have enough words to express my love and respect to both of them. They taught me so well that instead of doing electronics engineering, I opted for computers, and computers were very new during those times. I passed out from St. Anselm School, Ajmer. The best part was that they mingled the students in the lectures. They used to have the lectures very interactive. They created interest in students for programming. Basic was taught during those days. But let me tell you that concept is still same. Whatever language you go for, the logic of doing any programming is still same. Only syntax and command changes. So before I start with the code, let me explain to you what is matrix multiplication. I'll use the same logic that these teachers used to teach us, and it was very easy, and still I apply it to my students and they find it very easy to understand matrix multiplication. It basically requires the concept of nesting of loops. We'll see to it just while doing the coding. Suppose this is a matrix. This is the first matrix of order 2x3. When I say the order 2x3 means 2 rows and 3 columns. This is another matrix of order 3x4, that means 3 rows and 4 columns. For matrix multiplication, there is a prerequisite condition that the column of the first matrix should be equal to the row of the second matrix. If they don't match, matrix multiplication is not possible. So I repeat, the condition for matrix multiplication is that the column of the first matrix should be equal to the row of the second matrix. And the multiplied matrix, the resultant matrix, will be of order 2x4. This column of the first and the row of the second will neutralize. So the resultant matrix will be of order 2x4. This is the resultant matrix of order 2x4. Can you see there are 2 rows and 4 columns? How the matrix multiplication has happened? See, this location is first row, first column. This is first row, second column. First row, third column. That way, right? So this location is first row, first column. So you have to always take the row of the first matrix and column of the second matrix. And you have to just multiply the respective elements and add them. Like for example, this location is first row, first column. So you will take this first row and the first column of this matrix and multiply the respective element. That is, this 4 will be multiplied by 5, plus this 1 will be multiplied by 8, plus this 2 will be multiplied by this 6. See, 4 by 5 plus 1 by 8 plus 2 by 6. I repeat for this second region also. This region is your first row, second column. So you have to always take the row of the first matrix. So first row and this second column. You have to multiply and add the respective elements. This 4 will be multiplied by 7, plus 1 will be multiplied by 3, plus 2 will be multiplied by 1. Can you see that? Again, like for example, let's take this location. This is your which row? Second row and second column. So you have to take the second row of this matrix and second column of this matrix and multiply the respective elements. This 6 will be multiplied by 7, plus 0 will be multiplied by 3, and 3 will be multiplied by 1. Can you see that? When you multiply and add, this is what you get, and the final you get this value. So this is the matrix multiplication. This is a code for that. Before understanding this code, let's run it, whether this code is working or not. I'm going to run this C program on Unix environment, and I'm using Kigvin for doing so. Kigvin is a package that gives you an environment to run Unix commands on Windows. So when you double click it, you get this screen. And I've already written a program for you. That is matrix multi.c, the code that we'll understand. This is the code for that. Let's first compile it. I'm using GCC compiler for compiling it. No error. So let's run this. It is asking you to enter the elements for the first matrix. The order is 2x3, though that means you have to enter 6 values. So let's enter anything. It is asking you to enter the elements for the second matrix. The order is 3x4, that is you have to enter 12 values. I can either enter one value at a time. After every value, I can press enter key. Or I can also enter in this format, say. So this is that. This is a matrix multiplied. Let's understand the code for this now. This is that code. There are two matrices, as I said. One is your first matrix. I'm calling it mat A. It is of order 2x3. This is mat B, matrix 2. and the resultant matrix, as I said earlier, that the condition for matrix multiplication is that column of the first matrix should be equal to the row of the second, and these will neutralize. This 3 and this 3 will neutralize, and the resultant matrix will be 2 by 4. Can you see this? This mat R, I am using it for the multiplied matrix. Here the multiplied matrix will be stored. I am asking the user to enter the elements for the first matrix. This is nesting of loops. When you have one loop inside another, we call it nested. And it is a rule that the inner loop will run faster. See how? What is the value of I? 0 in the first round. And what is the value of J in the first round? It's 0 again. When the control reaches here on this basis, the value of J will increment. The value of I is 0, J is 0. When the cursor comes here, the value of J will increment to 1. It will ask the user to enter value. The value of J will increase to 2. While the value of J was increasing from 0 to 2, the value of I was fixed. The value of I will increment only when the J crosses its limit. When the value of J becomes 3, it is no more less than 3. The cursor will come over here. The value of I will increment to 1. It will come here. And again, the J will be initialized to 0. The value of J will increment from 0. It will increase to 1, 2. During that period, the value of I will be still 1. So the inner loops runs faster. Make it very clear that I is representing row here and J is representing column, and you are entering the values in the row major form. So that is, you are entering the values for the first row, because the value of I is 0 during that period. In almost all programming languages, the subscript, the index begins with 0. So when I say 0th row, that means in our language it is the first row. When the value of I will become 1, the values will be entered for the second row. So this is taking the values of the first matrix. After this nesting of loops is over, you are asking the user to enter the elements for the second matrix. The order is 3 by 4. I represents row. I will go from 0 to less than 3. That is, it will go from 0, 1 and 2. As I said, the first row is considered as 0th row in computer language. And this is the column. So again, this nested loops will run. It will ask the elements for the second matrix. Because you are multiplying and then adding, it's a rule that for adding in any element, that element where the result is stored has to be initialized to 0. Because almost all languages take the garbage value if you are not initializing. So what I am doing, in the resultant matrix, you are initializing its values to 0. Because you are not only multiplying, you are adding those elements and storing it into the resultant matrix. As I have told you, the resultant matrix will be of order 2 by 4. This 3 will be neutralized. It's making all its elements to 0. Now this is the logic that my teachers taught me, and I remember it still, and I apply it in my teaching still today. My students understand it and love this concept. It's so easy to understand. As I said, the resultant matrix will be of order 2 by 4. I represent row, J represent column. So can you see that this is the resulting matrix, 2 by 4. This, the third nested loop is for the neutralizing factor. This is neutralizing factor. Can you see that? 3. So the loop will go from this 0 to less than 3. And here what you're doing, you are multiplying and adding. As I said that you have to always take the row of the first and column of the second row. Can you see that I here and J here? So I represents row. So what you're doing, that you are multiplying the row of the first matrix with the column of the second. See, J is here, I is here, and this K is neutralizing factor. You have to multiply the row of the first and with the column of the second, and you have to add it, add with the earlier element. So if you ever done the program of adding the sum of sequence numbers, you must have used the formula S equal to S plus I. S equal to S, because you have to add with the earlier value of S. So this is what you are doing. The earlier value of matrix in the resultant matrix, you are adding it with the multiplication of row of the first matrix and the column of the second matrix. So this is multiplying and adding with the earlier values. And then you are simply displaying it. This slash T is for tab. This is the escape sequence. This will keep a space between the elements of the matrix while displaying the values. And this is for line feed. After displaying one row, you are taking the cursor to the next row. If you don't use this slash T, the elements will appear adjacent to each other without any space. And this slash N, if you don't use it, all the elements will come in one row. If you find any problem in understanding this lecture, mail me at bmharwani@yahoo.com. And you can even mail me for getting the code. And for other videos, you can have a view to this channel. And please don't forget to subscribe my channel and write down your comments. I desperately need your comments so that I should know what topic to write on and whether you are liking it or not, whether the voice is clear or not. Are you able to understand me? Thank you so much. Have a nice day.